Hello everyone, welcome to the Power BI Zero to Hero playlist. My name is Sandeep Rathori. In this video, I will explain you Power BI user interface. This is the first look of Power BI desktop file. In header section, we have multiple tabs, file, home, insert, modeling, view, optimize and help. In right hand side, we have filters pane, visualization pane and data pane. In left hand side, we have report view, table view, model view and desk query view. In bottom, we have desktop layout view, mobile layout view, and you can see the Power BI pages. If you want to add new page in the Power BI file, just click on plus icon. After that, if you will right click on the page name, so from here you can create the duplicate page. You can rename, delete and hide the report page, and also you can move the report page from left to right and front to end. In middle of the report page, we have quick option to import the data from multiple sources such as Excel and SQL Server. If you want to create a table by typing and pasting the data, you can go with option 3rd. And if you don't have any sample data set to load, so you can use default sample data set which is provided by Microsoft Power BI. Just click here and click on load sample data set. Just select the sheet which you want to load and click on load. So you can see your data has been loaded successfully and you can find the data under data tab. And if you want to see the preview of this data, so just go to the table view and you can see the preview of the data. So these all are the part of the Power BI user interface. Now let's start from file tab. So from file tab, you can open the existing Power BI file. You can save and share the Power BI file. You can get data from multiple sources. You can import and export the file content and you can publish the report into a service. And this one is the most important option under file tab, which is option and settings. So here you can see the two options. First one is option and second one is data source setting. So from data source setting, you can manage or modify the connection string for existing file or sources. And from options, you can manage the file setting and also you can manage the preview and features setting for Power BI report file. Here you can see the two sections. First one is global and second one is current file. So let's suppose I want to change the data load setting for current file. So I will go to the current file section. I will open the data load. And from here, I will check the setting. I will check or uncheck the setting and click on OK button. So it will impact to only current file. And might be after that, Power BI file restart is required. So just restart your Power BI file means you just close the existing file and reopen it. So it will impact to only current file. In same way, if you want to change the file setting for all Power BI report, so go to the global section and open the data load. And from here, you can change the setting and click on OK button. And after that, just restart the Power BI file. So this setting will implement for all Power BI report file. Here is one important feature is preview and features. Just open this one. And whenever Microsoft release any new changes or visuals or features, so it will visible here. So from here, you can enable or disable the feature for Power BI report file. So let's suppose I want to enable on object interaction feature for all Power BI report. So I will check this feature and click on OK button. After that, I will restart my Power BI file. So it will visible in all Power BI report file. Because you can see this option is comes under global. So it will impact to all Power BI report file. Now move to the home tab. So from home tab, you can get data from multiple sources. You can transform the data. So transform the data means, let's suppose you load the data and you want to change the data type or you want to rename the column, you want to remove the duplicate rows, right? So if you want to perform these kind of operations, so all things comes under transformation. So just click here. It will open the Power Query Editor window. And from here, you can perform the transformation. Just go to the transform tab. And you can see here, we have a lot of options. You can replace the value, you can pure or unpure the data, you can split the column, you can change the data type from here, right? So these kind of operation you can perform here. Now just close this. And after that you can create the visualization. And also you can write the DAX measure here and after that you can publish the report into Power BI service. Now move to the insert tab. So from insert tab, you can add the visualization in the report page. And also you can add the text box, buttons, saves and image in the report page. And from here you can also add the new page and duplicate page. Now move to the modeling. So basically model type is used for to manage the relationship between tables. So right now I have only one data set in my Power BI Desktop file. So that's the reason manage relationship option is disabled for me. If I upload more than one data set, then this option will be visible for me. And then you can create the relationship between multiple tables. From here, you can create the new measures, new calculate columns. You can also create the new tables to using the DAX expression. You can also create the field parameter. And the most important thing is you can create the rollable security. Means you can restrict the data from unauthorized users. Now move to the view tab. So from view tab, you can manage the theme for report page. You can also manage the page view size. You can switch between Power BI Desktop view to mobile layout view. And from here, you can create the bookmark, synchronize slicer, and performance analyzer. You can check the performance of visuals and DAX queries. In upcoming video, I will explain each and everything in detail view. Right now, I am just giving you short description. Now move to the optimize tab. So from optimize tab, you can use the performance analyzer and you can optimize the bottleneck. Means if your DAX query is returning the slow result or visual is loading slow, so you can enable the performance analyzer and then you can check which visual is taking too much time to load, which query is taking too much time to load, right? So then after that, you can optimize that DAX query or visuals. Now move to the help tab. So from help tab, you can check the Power BI Desktop version. So just click on about, so it will show you the version name. And if you want to access the documentation or learning guide of Power BI, so just click here. So it will navigate to relevant website. And also you can take support from here. And also you can access the Power BI blog. And if you want to join the Power BI community, so you can access from here. So that's all about help tab. Now move to the filters pane. So from filters pane, you can filter the report page data. Through visualization pane, you can add the visuals in the report page. And here you can see the value section, right? So in value section, you will drag the column so that data will display in the visuals. Whatever data you load in the Power BI Desktop, so it will be visible under data pane. Now we have report view. So report view means this area. So here you will create the visualization. So this will comes under report view. So by default, if you notice here, this icon is highlighted, means right now we are in report view. Next we have table view. So if you want to see the preview of the data, so just click on table view and from here you can see the preview of data. Third one is model view. So in model view, you can manage the relationship between multiple tables. So right now I have only single table, so that's the reason I cannot create the relationship here. But in upcoming videos, I will explain each and everything in detail level. And last we have DAX query view. So in DAX query view, you can see the data of your semantic model. So let's suppose you have any measure and you want to see the output of your measure without drag that measure in the visualization, so you can use the DAX query view. So in upcoming videos, I will show you the demo for this in detail level. So that's all for this video. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the notification bell for more great content. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.